young people are mostly very emotional. The actions and reactions of a young boy or girl are influenced by emotions so much that they very rarely bother about the consequences of what they are doing. This is often found in case of love and marriage. The result of such rash and reckless activities on the part of young men is that they very often lead to difficult situations for themselves. And not only this, such rash and reckless activities on their part often creates difficulty for others also. It often ruins other people's happiness also. This story, Suitor and Papa by Anton Chekhov, will deal with such themes. So before we start the story, let us know something about the author, Anton Chekhov. He was born in 1860 in Russia and died in 1904 in Germany. He was a Russian national, a Russian citizen, and he is one of such other authors or poets whose writings you have already studied, who are not Englishmen, but they write in English. In general English first year, you have got Khushwant Singh's beautiful narrative, The Portrait of a Lady, and Faiz Ahmad Faiz's poem, When Winter Came. In second year, again, you will get other Indian writers like R.K. Narayan and Sarojini Naidu. So, Anton Chekhov is one such person whose mother language is not English, but he wrote in English and he became famous as a dramatist and as a writer of short stories. And he is one of the most famous English short story writers of the world. And in this story, Suitor and Papa, you see, the first word is suitor. The word suitor, it has come from the word suit. S-U-I-T, it's pronounced as suit, not sweet. And from this suit, we have got the word suitable. It's not suitable, it's suitable. What is this suit? Suit is used as a noun also, and as a verb also. As a noun, it means it is a kind of dress made of fabric, made of design, which you wear over your shirt. That is suit. It is like something like a blazer or a coat. And suit as a verb, it means one meaning is that something that is to be convenient to. To be suitable, to be eligible. For example, this place doesn't suit me. It means this place is not comfortable for me. I don't find comfortable in this place. This place doesn't suit me. Another meaning of suit as a verb again is to pursue a girl for marriage. If you are having a relationship with a girl and she is going to be your wife, you are maintaining such a relationship, then you are suiting the girl. And you are the suitor. So this is the sense in which the word suitor is used. Suitor means a guy who is pursuing a girl, who is in a relationship with a girl whom he considers to be his prospective wife. Suitor and Papa. So suitor is a young man here. He was in a relationship with a girl, and Papa, the father, is the young girl's father. The story is very beautiful, and at the same time it carries a lot of tragic messages, sad messages, and how the an old man who has seven daughters, and he is burdened with this responsibility of marrying those daughters off to suitable boys, and how his expectations and all his aspirations and dreams are ruined when this young man, suitor, suddenly starts behaving in a different way. And the end is a mixture of tragedy and comedy. It is a comedy so far as the suitor is concerned. It is a relief for him. And so far as the father is concerned, it's a tragedy. It ends with a sad note for the father. So let us start the story then. Suitor and Papa by Anton Chekhov. It begins with a conversation. The whole story is actually mainly a conversation between this young man and the girl's father. And the beginning is a small conversation between this suitor, the young man, and his friend. His friend is asking him a question, asking him, "You are getting married, I hear," said one of his friends to Piotr Petrovich Milkin at the summer ball. "When are you going to throw away your state party?" This is the question. So, you see, some important words are here which may be new to you. First, Piotr Petrovich Milkin is the main character. He is the suitor. He is the young man. You see the spelling. Piotr Petrovich Milkin is his full name. And a friend of Piotr asked him that, "I have heard that you are going to get married. And where do they meet?" They meet at a summer ball. This summer ball, the word ball may be confused here, may be confusing to you here. This ball is not that object which you use for playing soccer or for playing other games. This ball is actually a festival, a university festival, when the new batch of students, after their freshers week is over, then there is a festival for them. It is called ball. Again, the final year students, when they are going to leave the university, they also have a festival for themselves. That is called a ball. So when it happens in the month of June, in summer, it is called summer ball. So summer ball here is a festival in the university where Milkin was told by his friend that, "I have heard that you are going to get married, so when are you going to throw away?" Throw away here does not mean to throw a thing, the way we just toss something, it is not that. Throw away means give a party. And then the state party. What is the state party? The meaning is given at the bottom of the page. A state party is a party that is given by a man who is going to get married, and in such a party he invites only his male friends. So that is the practice, that is a part of their culture. So everybody knows it, that if a man is going to get married, he will definitely invite his male friends before marriage. So Milton's friend is asking him this thing, that, "I have heard that you are getting married, and when are you going to give your state party?" This question startles Milkin. He is shocked at this. He said, "Why did you hear I was getting married?" said Milkin, blushing. "What fool told you that?" Milkin blushed, B-L-U-S-H, blush. Blush means that your face shows redness because of embarrassment, because of anger. If you were angry or embarrassed or shy, and this is projected on your face becomes red. This reddening to your face becoming red because of anger, nervousness or embarrassment, that is called blush. So hearing this question from his friend, Milkin blushed. He became red in his face, and angrily he asked, "Why did you hear I was getting married? What fool told you that?" And then the friend is saying, everybody is saying so, and everything goes to show it. No use covering up, my dear fellow. Don't show your anger. Don't think that it is unknown. Everybody knows this thing, that you are getting married. And everything goes to show it. It means all your movements, your activities, whatever you are doing these days, these things also tell us that, yes, you are about to get married. And then the friend said, no use covering up. Covering up means hiding. Don't try to hide it. Don't try to keep it a secret from us. It is no more a secret. It is known to all. Then the friend continues. In the next paragraph, he gives a detailed account of why they think so. How they came to know that Milkin was going to get married. This friend is making a details of it. He's saying, you think we don't know anything, but we can see right through you and we know. Everything goes to show it. You spend whole days with the Kondrashkins. The Kondrashkins. This is a very nice use of proper noun with in plural form. The Kondrashkins. This Kondrashkin without S. This Kondrashkin is the title of the family where this Milkin is having a relationship with a girl. And when you use the before a proper noun and then put S at the end of it, usually proper nouns are not plural, are not made into plural, but this is a technique. The I is used before it, at the end, as it put the Kandarskins, it means the Kandarskin family, the family of people who for whom Kandarskin is the common title. For example, the Bhattacharjis, it means I am talking about the family whose title is Bhattacharji, all the people there are Bhattacharji. When you talk about the whole family, then you use it in this way, da before it, as at the end of the proper noun. So his friend is telling him, you spend whole day with the Kandarskins, you have dinner there, you have supper there, you sing ballads. Yeah, we all know you spend your whole day in the Kandarskin family, you take dinner there, you have supper there. Supper is the light food taken in the evening. And then you sing ballads. Ballads means love song. You sing love songs with the girls there. You don't go for walks with anyone except Nastya Kandraskina. Nastya Kandraskina is the name of that girl with whom Milkin was having an affair. And she is the only one you take bunches of flowers to. You take bunches of flowers for no one else except that girl. We see everything. I met Nastya's father the other day and he says it's in the bag. In the bag. In the bag means certain. It means the issue of marriage is something confirmed. It is sure. It is going to take place definitely. Milton's friend is telling him that I met that girl's father. And he told me the other day that the marriage is in the bag. It means the marriage is sure to take place. And the wedding will take place as soon as you move back to town from the country. Country here means village. You are in the village, and the girl's father told me that once you come back from village to the town, then the day will be fixed. And the issue of marriage is something that is definite. Then he is asking, well, God bless you. I am glad for Kandraskin's sake rather than yours. You are my friend, so you are getting married. I should be happy, but I am more happy because of that old man, because he has got 7 daughters and this is a burden for him. So at least if he can marry one of his daughters off, some of his burden will be lessened. So he is saying that the poor fellow has got 7 daughters. 7. That's no joke. At least he has got one of them fixed up. And here then you have the word dinner. One interesting thing is dinner, we all know. Dinner is the food that you take at night. And the verb is dine. Dine is to take food at night. That is dining. It is an activity. And dinner is the food itself. And there is another word with only single D, a single M. Here dinner, N is double. Here N is single. What is this? This is diner. Not dinner. This is diner. Diner is a person who dines. In the same way, a person who teaches is a teacher. A person who drives a car is a driver. A person who dines is a diner. So this is diner and this is dinner. So his friend, Milton's friend, has given him the whole detailed account of how they have presumed that he was going to get married. And now Milton finds it difficult to say anything else. It is impossible for him to hide the fact from them. He just says, blast, thought me. Blast means it is an expression of anger, an expression of helplessness. What happened? All came to know this the way we say that tarika, that is blast, thought Milken. That's the 10th one who had told me I am marrying Nastya. How did they work that out? Damn them. Earlier we found that Milken asked his friend, who told you? What fool told you? But now the fact is coming out that he is telling us that this family is not the only person who asked him this question. Before him, 9 similar persons have asked him, and he is the 10th one. This means everyone knows this thing. All his friends, all his close acquaintances, they are very familiar with this kind of thing. They know it very well that he was having a relation with this girl and he was going to marry her. How did they work that out? Work out means to get an idea, to have an idea. Work out. Work something out. It means get an idea. How do they come to get such ideas? How do they think that I am getting married? How do they know all these things? This is what is confusing for Milken. Then he is justifying. He says, yes, because I dine every day. I dine. Dine is the verb. Because I dine every day at the Kandraskins and go for walks with her. Yes, he now realizes, yes, I visit their home every day. I take dinner there. That's why people have come to know this thing. Then he says, no, it's time to stop these rumors. It's definitely time. Or before I know where I am, they will get me hitched, the meneses. Hitched. Hitched means get me hitched. Get someone. Hitched means to get someone married. It means they will force me to marry. If I don't make any change, if I continue going to their home, then a time will come, then they will compel me to marry. And the way I am behaving, I know, yes, anyone will believe like that. So it is time, I should not make any delay in it. Then he said, the meneses. The word menes means disturbance, difficulty. And here the word menes means people who are very annoying. These people who are asking me the same question, they are a disturbance for me. And those familiars, they will also get an advantage if I continue going. So it is time to stop going there, to go and tell them that no, I am not in any relationship, don't hope anything from me. Then he says, I'll drop in tomorrow. Drop in means I'll visit their home tomorrow and sort it out with that blockhead of a Kandraskin. The word blockhead is important here. Blockhead. Blockhead means a stupid person, an idiot. And who is the idiot here? Milken is using the word stupid or blockhead for that respectable person, that unfortunate fellow, Nestor's father. The very person who all these days entertained him, he harbored him, he allowed him to visit his home with the expectation that this young man will marry my daughter. And now, this young man, since he has found that he it is a matter of responsibility, I had a relationship all these days, but now it is a question of marriage and they will compel me to get married if I continue the relationship. Out of anger, he is using the word blockhead for that man who otherwise would have been his father-in-law. So he says, I'll visit their home tomorrow and I'll talk to that idiot, the Kondraskin, and I'll tell him that he won't hope in vain. He should not hope anything from me. That will be fruitless. Any hope from me, from my end, that I'm going to marry his daughter, that will be a fruitless hope. That will go in vain. So I'll tell him this thing. And then, this is an expression of displeasure, an expression of anger. On the day after this conversation, an embarrassed and somewhat frightened Milken went into court counselor Kondraskin's study. The very next day, Milken actually visited their home. And when he went there, he was embarrassed and he was frightened. Embarrassed because he was not feeling ease, he was not feeling comfortable. Why? Because he knew that all these days the relationship was very smooth and he used to spend long time there, take dinner and supper, and he would give bunches of flowers to the guard. He would walk along with the guard all alone on the street. And now suddenly he's going to tell something really shocking, something they never expected. Telling such a thing all of a sudden is not that easy a job. That's why he was embarrassed. At the same time, he was frightened, afraid. Why frightened? Because who knows, maybe after they come to know this shocking news, they will all give him a very good beating. Rampiton they will give him. That's why he was afraid also. And he went into court counselor. Kondraskin was the court counselor. What is this court counselor? A court counselor, the position is no more in practice now, it was there earlier. A court counselor was a person who was a government official in the court. He would help the government proceeding of the court on behalf of the government. That is the court counselor. And Milken went to his court counselor's study. Study here does not mean what we mean by study in general. Study here means the chamber where Kondraskin would do his professional study. It is his chamber. There he would sit and he would prepare for his court. He would make his professional study there. That is the chamber. That is called study. So Milken went there to meet Kondraskin. Seeing him, Kondraskin, the old man, he was very happy because he knew nothing about what is there in the mind of Milken. He, as usual, was very happy to find him after many days. And he said, Pyotr Petrovich, said his host in greeting, in a tone of greeting, in a welcoming tone, in a happy tone, the old man welcome this young man, and the way he used his name as if, yes, I am welcoming you, I am happy seeing you. Peter Petrovich, how are we getting on? How is it that you have come and we are meeting? How is it? Missing her. Then he is teasing, teasing Milkin that, yes, since you are in love with my daughter, and I am sure that after all these days you spent a long time at your home, you must have missed my daughter. So he is asking, missing her. Nastya will be here in a jiffy. Jiffy means within a short time. Nastya will be here in a jiffy. J-I-F-F-Y-G-G means a short while, a short time. Within a short time, Nastya will be coming. Right now, she is not available at home. She has just popped over. Pop over means gone or visited. She has gone to another family in the neighborhood. What family is it? The Gusabs. Like the one we got earlier, the Kondraskins. Again, you see the Gusabs. The I is there. At the end, there is S. The Gusabs means the family of Gusabs. She has gone there for a little while and she will come back very soon. But Milkin has gone today not for any such regular activities. He has gone with a different purpose, in a different mood. And he starts speaking, but he could not speak that smoothly. He said, as a matter of fact, I haven't come for Anastasia Kirillovna. That is another name for that girl. I haven't come to meet your daughter, Anastasia Kirillovna. Mumbled Milkin. Mumble means he was not able to speak with clarity. He spoke in a low voice. In an inaudible voice, in a nervous tone, he spoke. He said, I have not come to meet her. While saying this, scratching his eye in embarrassment. He was embarrassed, and when you are embarrassed, you can do different bodily activities. For example, scratching your eye, it means you are not able to face the person, you are not having this confidence. So he was scratching his eyes as a mark of embarrassment, and he said, I have come to see you. There is a certain matter I must discuss with you. I have got something in my eye. As an excuse for scratching his eye, he said, I have got some problem in my eyes. So it is not as if to hide his nervousness, he is saying this. He said, I have come to meet you only. I have something very important to discuss with you only. Still, the old man is not getting any clue about what is there in the mind of the man, because old man is simple. All these days he has found that this boy had a very healthy relation, much friendship with my daughter. In that tone he is speaking only. He says, and what is it you intend to discuss? Said Kondraskin with a wink. Wink means with a blink of eye, in a joking mood, in a funny mood, as a gesture of happiness, as a gesture of sweetness. He says, and what is it you intend to discuss? Why are you so flustered? Flustered means why are you so nervous? Why can't you speak properly? You are nervous, my dear chap. Chap means young man. You are very nervous. Wait behind the ears. Wet behind the ears. What is this? Wet behind the ears means that you are very young and you do not have the experience of life and you do not know how to approach an old man to talk about his daughter's marriage. Because having an affair with a girl, being someone's boyfriend, spending time with her is one thing. And when it comes to marriage, the official talk, how the preparation should be, what should be the date, and all the things about the wedding. That is something that needs some mature people, some people with experience. They know how to deal with these things. You are only a young man, you do not have experience of life, so you find it very difficult to talk about how you should proceed with our wedding, etc. That's why I am sure, wait behind the ears means you are lagging in experience of life, you are very young, you do not know how to approach, how to start talking about the ceremony. That's why you are nervous. No, I know what you want to discuss. It's about time. I know you have come to discuss about the date of marriage, to fix the date of marriage. And so since it is your marriage and I am the girl's father, that's why you find it uncomfortable to discuss. That is the difficulty. That is what makes you nervous. I understand it. Milkin has to now tell the thing, and he see how difficult it is for him to speak. Earlier we got that he was really embarrassed. Before he could tell the main thing, he made three introductory phrases he used. and he could not easily start speaking. He said, to put it in a nutshell, then he says, in a manner of speaking, still he could not tell the main thing. He said, the fact of the matter is that, and now he says, I have come to say goodbye to you, I am leaving tomorrow. How do you mean, leaving? Asked Konarskin, his eyes bulging. Bulging means wide open. It is really something very shocking. What do you mean? Leaving? The man is really shocked, and with his bulging eyes he asked this question. Making seems quite simply, leaving, that's it, that's all. Yes, I am leaving, that's it. Simple thing. Permit me to thank you for your cordial hospitality. Your daughters are so nice. I shall never forget the moments which... He said, yeah, I am leaving. And I am very grateful to you for the cordial hospitality. What is this cordial hospitality? Cordial means friendly. And hospitality, it looks like hospital. The word, it looks like hospital. But its meaning, the hospitality is an abstract noun. It means the treatment, the behavior, the friendship, the gesture that you receive from a host when you visit someone's home. You are visiting somebody's home. And then when you go there, they welcome you, please, yes, come, please, yes, yes, sit there, yes. Then they bring you drink and other food items, and they take care of you, and they tell you, take rest there, go there. They take every care of you, they show their love for you. All these things, their manners, their friendship, their gesture of friendship, everything is called hospitality, atitto, or mehmandari. The way a guest is behaved, a guest is treated by the host, is called hospitality. Maybe the word has some link with the word hospital. It looks like hospital. What I suppose is that actually such things should be there more in hospital. Something that in a hospital, actually a patient is helpless. He has gone away from his home. All his comfort, it depends on the staff, the nurse, the doctor there. So this kind of behavior, the treatment that a guest receives, should actually be available in a hospital. That is how maybe there is a link. Unfortunately, there is an irony that in hospital you do not get it. So, what happens here is that he said, I have received cordial hospitality from your family, and I am thankful for it. Your daughters are so nice. By this nice, he means well behaved. Their manners are very good, they are very friendly. I shall never forget the moments which, yes, he is continuing. But suddenly the old man could not tolerate it. It was a shocking news for him. It was something something that was as if it was like a thundering sound for him. What I am hearing? What is he saying? He said, allow me, said Konarskin, going purple in the face. Going purple in the face means he became really, really very angry, and he was helpless. He could not make out what happened. So he said, allow me, I don't quite understand you. Of course, every man has the right to go away. You can do whatever you please. But my dear sir, you are evading the issue. It is dishonest. Konarskin said, I can't understand what you mean. Yes, everybody has the right to leave. Anyone can leave. But so far as you are concerned, with regard to our home, the frequent visits you made to our home, the long time you spent with us, the time you spent with my daughters, and now you are saying you are going, that is, you are evading the issue. Evading means you are escaping from the issue. You are just trying to avoid the issue. That is not an honest activity. That is something dishonest. Then Milton said, I don't understand in what way I am evading the issue. How am I evading the issue? How am I escaping? The old man says, you have been coming here all summer, eating, drinking, chatting to the girls, morning, noon, and night, and then suddenly I am leaving, so there. Yes, you are evading the issue, you are doing something dishonest, because all these days you came to our home all the summer, eating, drinking, chatting, every time you were here, in the morning, at night, in the noon, and now suddenly you come and abruptly you say, I am leaving. Milton said, I don't encourage any hopes. Yes, I came, I spent time with them, but I don't encourage any hopes. It means I did not behave in a way that your girls or you should think that you should hope that, yes, I am going to marry one of them. I am going to marry Nestia. There is a friendship. I spent very very happy time with them. I agree. I am thankful for it. But I never showed any kind of behavior that should create any hope in your mind about me being your daughter's prospective husband. But this statement of Milken does not hold good. All the things that we have so far got from this, it is clear to us that when you have done all these things, nothing is left. That is enough to prove that yes, you are in a relationship. What more should you do to say that? You may say that I have not formally declared before a group of people, I love her, I am going to marry her. That you might not have done, but all your activities and your movements and actions and reactions, they are enough to prove that you are having an affair. So the talk between the young man and the old man, Milken and Kondraskin, will continue. And the next person will be more entertaining. You will see how the young man tries to convince the old man to accept him, to allow him to leave. And the old man is not at all ready to ask him, yes, go. That is really very interesting. This we will find in the next part of the video. Thank you very much for being with me.